This is a demonstration of the SmartDraft Create Reports command, which is a parcel tool found in the SmartDraft Suite and SmartDraft Survey products. This command can be used to create area and closure reports or legal descriptions from Civil 3D and SmartDraft parcels. I'll open a Civil 3D drawing which already has defined 58 lots, one open space, and four street right-of-ways in a site called Wilsey Park. So if we were to open up the sites, you'll see Wilsey Park, and under the parcels, all the lots, the open space lot, and the four roads that are inside this project. To start the command, we go to the Parcels panel on the SmartDraft ribbon. Select this icon, or type PRR at the command prompt. In the Create Reports dialog box, the first option is to select either SmartDraft parcels or Civil 3D parcels. In this drawing, there are no SmartDraft parcels, so we will stay with what is pre-selected Civil 3D parcels. If there are multiple sites, they will all be listed in the Sites drop-down, but we only have one, Wilsey Park. In the display box, you will see all the available parcels listed. You can either individually select them, holding down the Command or Shift, and select individual, or select the All button to select all the parcels within this project. Once one or more of the parcels have been selected, the operator has an option to create one of three reports from the selected parcels. Either area, this creates a report of the parcel's name, square footage or meters, acres or hectares, and the perimeter. The closure button is used to create a closure report for the selected parcels, and the legal button is used to create a legal description for the selected parcels. Let's look at the area report first. In the area report options, you have an option to include a company name or not, a report name, a project number, a project name, the author or creator, and do you want to include today's date? In the output options, you have two formats, text or comma delimited, so that you can import that into Excel. For the feet and acres, there are prefixes that you can add or suffixes. You can modify the decimal precision of the feet and acres and the decimal precision of the perimeter value. If you would like your report to have all text uppercase, check the box All Text Uppercase. In Civil 3D and SmartDraft, you're allowed to put a description with each parcel. If you want to include any entered descriptions, check the Include Parcel Descriptions option. And if at the end you would like a total of all the selected parcels, select the Include Totals for Selected Parcels. Let's view this report, and you'll see that it has parcel name, the perimeter, the area and square footage, and in acres in this particular case. And as we browse to the end, you see that it has the total area of the parcels selected, both in the square units that we have and acres or hectares. Let's look at one more format, the comma delimited format. If we exclude all the header information and we view this report, this file can now be saved off and imported into the spreadsheet through comma delimited format. So now I will cancel out the area report options, and let's look at the closure report options. So we start the command again going to the parcels panel, selecting this icon. I will select all of the parcels, select the closure button. Here again, in the header, we have the option to include the same items with one addition. Each traverse or closure can be printed on a new page if you select this option. There are two output formats, a SmartDraft format and an Autodesk format, the one that looks much like LAN Desktop and or the analysis that is inside Civil 3D. There are closure methods, bearing and chord data, or by bearing, radius, and delta. When it comes to printing off linear information, you can change the linear precision. When it's showing feet or meters, you can change that precision, acres, that precision, and any suffix that are added to those items. There is an angular format, degrees with the degrees, minutes, seconds symbol, degrees, minutes, seconds with a dash between them, or degrees, minutes, seconds without any degrees, minutes, seconds symbols. You can change the angular precision, and you can change the coordinate precision. If you want all the text to be uppercase, again, select this button, including any descriptions entered. You can check it, this box. If you want additional spaces between each course, select include a space between each course. If you want the total of all the parcels when you're done, check this box. And a new option, include point numbers. If you check this option, it will ask you to specify where the point information will come from. Either the survey database, in this particular case there isn't one open, points in the drawing, and then you can use groups, selection, type of range. So because we do have include points, and we say view, it's going to ask us, we want to select all, range, group, layer. I'm just going to select all. And as it generates the closure information for each one of those parcels, you will see for parcel 1, you have the course information, the coordinate, and the point number. Course information for the radius going in, point number, the arc information, the radius going out, and so on and so forth for each course. An area of closure, the bearing, the distance for that, the total area of that parcel, both in square units and acres, the perimeter, and the precision of the closure. And it will do this for each one of the parcels. And then when you get to the end, it gives you a total of all of the areas that you did closures for. If you want to print this report off, or save it to a file, you can do so by selecting the appropriate button. Now let's do one more demonstration. Start the command again. This time we'll select one lot, go to legal description. Again, all the same header information. There are a bunch of different styles. You can have preambles, postambles going into the legal description style manager and set those up. Here we're just going to use the default. Again, setting your suffixes to various information, your precision information, decimal precision, the angular printout, degrees, minutes, seconds written out. Do you want it to have just a symbol, a dash between them, or no symbol? What precision it's going to be? When it comes to direction, do you want the whole word north, south, east, and west written, or just first letter of those directions? When it writes curve information, do you want it to have the word left and right in front of it? Or do you want to have concave direction? When it comes to curve data, do you want it to do radials, non-tangent, radials all? Or do you want it to have chord data? When it's doing numbering, do you want it to have these various numbering methods? Again, between each course, do you want additional spaces so that there's information in between each course? Do you want the whole report to be uppercase? And do you want to include the description that was entered in through Civil 3D or SmartDraft? Let's view this report. And here you have the closure using the default style. Now we can close out of this information. If you want to print or save that to a file, you can do so by picking either the print or save button. I'll close out the legal description report options. This concludes our demonstration of the Create Reports command in SmartDraft. Thank you.